Good morning, students.
Here, small activity is there. If you take a moist piece of bread or bhakri and keep it in a container with lid for 2 to 3 days, after 2 to 3 days, a fine cotton thread-like tuft is found growing on the surface of the bread. And if we prepare the smear from that, and if we observe under the microscope, then this type of structure can be observed. Commonly in rainy season, when there is a moisture is present in a large amount, in that period, on the surface of bhakri or chapati or dal, this type of fungi grow. That means, what is the bottom line for that? For the growth of the fungi, moisture or moist place are required. If you observe the diagram of fungi, here rhizoids are present. Rhizoids are nothing but the root-like structure, but they are not actually roots. False root, we can say. Hypha, apophysis, sporangium. Sporangium, a balloon-like structure is there. In that, spores are developed. And when that the spore get properly matured, well developed, at the proper condition, that sporangium get break, and inside that, whatever the spores are present, these spores comes out and they settled on the moist place, and there is a multiplication is occur. In this way, growth of fungi is occur. If we discuss the characteristics, first it is these are non-green eukaryotic heterotrophic organisms. Non-green, that means chloroplast or chlorophyll is absent. That means photosynthesis to nahi hota hai inme. Eukaryotic in nature, and heterotrophic, that means they depend upon the other things for their food purpose. Most of them are the saprotrophs. Saprotrophs or saprophytes, both are the same. What is the meaning of this word? They feed upon decaying organic matter. That species are called as the saprotrophs or saprophytes. Third characteristics, their cell wall is made up of tough and complex sugar called as the chitin or chitin. Both pronunciations are correct one. Cell wall made up of chitin. Some fungi are thread-like and many nuclei are present in the cytoplasm. Thread-like structure is there, but if you observe the cytoplasm, many nucleus are present. Examples, Baker's yeast, Aspergillus. Aspergillus, that is a species which grow on the, that is the fungus which grow on the corn. Penicillium and mushrooms, these are the examples of the fungi. Yes. Though many systems of classification are introduced after the Whitaker's, his five kingdom system is widely accepted. Here, five kingdom classification, that discussion of this, it is over. Among the living organisms, microorganisms are largest in number. Why they are largest in number? Because their multiplication is very fast. It requires very less time. Hence, their number is largest in living organisms. So if we think about the microorganisms classification, then two types are there, prokaryotes, eukaryotes. Prokaryotes, in that, only one type is a bacteria, and eukaryotes, that is protista, fungi and algae, these three are included into the eukaryotes. Now, first it is the bacteria. If size, related to the size, if we discuss the size of bacteria, it is 1 micrometer to 10 micrometer. Characteristics, unicellular, that is one cell is there, independent or parasitic organisms. Parasitic means the organisms or the species that lives in another organism and nourishment is occur inside the another organism. They are called as the parasitic in nature. Second characteristics, bacterial cell is prokaryotic with cell wall, but distinct nucleus or cell organelles are absent. Prokaryotic cell is there, cell wall is present, but proper nucleus and cell organelles are absent. They reproduce by simple binary fission. Students, the meaning of binary fission, that means from one parent cell, when there is a there are two daughter cells are formed, it is called as a binary fission. Binary, that means two. Fourth one, in favorable condition, bacteria grow vigorously and can be double their number in 20 minutes. When there is a proper condition for their development, that means proper temperature, environmental condition is there, then their growth is occur very fastly and can be double their number in only 20 minutes. So the time requirement is very less time required for their multiplication, and in 20 minutes they doubled. In this way we say that therefore number of microorganisms are very huge in numbers among the all living organisms. Here some bacteria are there in diagram 1.7. Coccus, that is circular shaped bacteria, they are called as the coccus. Coccobacillus, that is slightly elongated structure of that bacteria, not proper circular, not properly elongated. They are called as the coccobacillus. Bacillus, that means proper elongated structure, capsule like structure is there, which is called as the bacillus. Lactobacilli or lactobacillus. Lacto, that means a type of sugar, lactose, it is present into the milk. Lactobacilli, their shape, it is elongated one. They present in the milk, therefore they are called as a lactobacilli. Vibrio. Vibrio, that is the comma shaped. Their shape is the comma. Vibrio cholerae, which causes the cholera. That bacterial species is the Vibrio cholerae. Spirillum. Spirillum, the bacterial species which are spiral in shape, they are called as the spirillum. In this way, according to their shape, these are the types of the bacteria. Next one, protozoa. Size of the protozoa, it is approximately 200 micrometer. Protozoans are found in soil, in fresh water also and sea water also. Some are found in body of other organisms and are pathogenic. Pathogenic, they causes the diseases. They are called as the pathogenic. These are unicellular organisms with eukaryotic cell. There is great variation in cell structure, organs of locomotion and modes of nutrition among the protozoans. Only in some protozoans only one flagella is present. Paramecium, suppose many cilia-like structure, hair-like projection is present for locomotion purpose. So here variations are observed. These organisms reproduce by simple cell division. From parent cell, simply there is a daughter cell are formed. Example, amoeba, paramecium, free living in dirty water. The species of amoeba and paramecium, they are present in the dirty water. They are free living, that means they can easily grow in dirty water. Entamoeba histolytica causes amoebiasis. This is a type of disease which is causes due to the entamoeba histolytica. Plasmodium vivax causes malaria. And Euglena, it is a autotrophic, self mode of nutrition is there. These four are the examples of the protozoa. Here diagram is there of paramecium and enteramoeba.